Welcome to the World News. I'm Randolph Jamias for Stories Today. Heavy downpour hit the Jordanian capital Amman for the second day on Tuesday, causing widespread flooding. The unexpected bad weather caused panic among inhabitants of the capital. Most government departments and schools and private businesses are set to remain closed on Wednesday in anticipation of more bad weather. Local weather reports expect a polar front to hit the country over the next couple of days, carrying more rain and possibly snow. And in Turkey, heavy snowfall caused disruptions in many parts of the country on Tuesday. Access to many villages had been blocked due to the extreme weather conditions. Rescue workers tried to help people stuck in their villages as ambulances could often not pass through roads with snow height climbing up to 1 meter in some parts of the country. The weather office says there will be strong snowfalls for the upcoming days in Turkey, with temperatures dropping to minus 12 degrees Celsius. Meanwhile, fire continued to burn near Jujong in Australia's New South Wales on Wednesday. Local media said no houses were lost in the flames, with one person believed to be missing. Around 400 kilometers west of Sydney in the town of Bogan Gate, firemen were busy fighting several blazes that hit the rural areas in New South Wales. Even though the temperatures are cooling in the southeast of the country and fires may ease, the Australian Bureau of Meteorology is forecasting 54 degrees Celsius in central Australia next Monday. And speaking of drought, the northeastern part of Brazil is experiencing the hot weather. The country's president, Dilma Rousseff, promised of building dams and irrigation dams, but the locals are giving up their hopes. Let's find out more.
In northeastern Brazil, signs of a drought are everywhere.
It was the worst year we had in 30 years. A lot of animals have died due to the lack of water and pasture. I believe 60% of the livestock in the region are gone, and the ones that didn't die were sold.
Farming communities like São José do Ijito have been hard hit by soaring temperatures. And the drought has gone on for so long that there isn't any grass for the animals. Locals say they're now feeding cacti to their livestock. President Dilma Rousseff in November discussed building dams and irrigation systems to reduce the impact on the area. But many have already given up hope, abandoning their farms completely. They say they've lost so much already that they can't go another month without rain.
In other news, TV makers showing off their new wares at a huge trade fair will seek to dazzle consumers with bigger, bolder displays and smarter technologies for consumers who want televisions to be multi-screen experience. Companies like Samsung, Sony, LG, Sharp, and Panasonic, showing at the International CES in Las Vegas this week, are making a new push for so-called Ultra HD, high definition of 4K, which can provide stunning, lifelike images at a steep price. Size is on the rise, with many consumers looking at screen measuring 60 inches, especially in the U.S. One initiative being pushed by cable firms is known as TV Everywhere, which enables consumers to take their subscriptions to other devices or even on the road.
That's really what our industry is all about, is innovation. So ultra-high definition, over-the-top services, OLED TVs that are impossibly thin. These are inspiring innovations that I think are going to really engage consumers in the years to come.
We announced in the U.S. market that we would begin taking a 55-inch OLED television and make that available in March for a price point of $12,000 U.S. So that's kind of the big, big news. For me, this has been a really thin phone to be able to use. When you compare this phone currently against the thinness of our TVs, it's just unparalleled.
Still on high-tech news, the president of Panasonic says the Japanese electronics maker will collaborate with General Motors and IBM in a wide range of IT-related businesses. That's in a bid to boost earnings and shed the firm's dependence on unprofitable TV division.
Kazuhiro Suga gave a keynote speech at the world's largest consumer electronics show in Las Vegas. Suga said Panasonic and GM, the U.S. automaker, has developed a system for communicating with a car using a smartphone. The system can connect to the internet to provide the latest navigation information and music. Panasonic will also work together with IBM, the U.S. IT giant, to strengthen its cloud computing division. Suga said the two firms will develop home appliances and services that are linked with the internet.
And in golf, it required a lot of patience and overtime, but American Dustin Johnson opened the PGA Tour season with a comfortable victory at the Windswept Tournament of Champions in Hawaii on Tuesday. Johnson fired a 5-under 68 on another blustery day at the Kapalua Resort to finish four shots clear of defending champion Steve Stricker. With the win, Johnson becomes the first player since Tiger Woods to win at least one tournament in six consecutive years straight out of college. American Brent Snedeker had a solid start to his 2013 campaign, also closing with a 69 to finish alone in third, six shots back at Johnson. Masters champion Bubba Watson was a further shot back in a tie for fourth with fellow American Keegan Bradley. Don't go away, we'll be back for more.